Good, y'all. What's good? I am back. It's Player Talk Radio back in full effect, man. I had a little hiatus, man. You know, I took a little time off, you know, to enjoy myself. So, man, listen, we're going to get into the mix, man. So, listen, man, if you got any emails or anything that you want to discuss with me, email me at playertalk8@gmail.com. That is playertalk8@gmail.com. So, listen, man, we got a lot to discuss tonight. We're going to get into the mix. So, get up with me, man. It's the kid, Young Kuda, man. Let's get into the mix, and then let's get into the show.
I just want it all, give it all. I just wanna pop it, then I fall. Then I fall. Got a lot of oxy in the zen. I've been cooking up in a damn cool. Oh, I'm gonna do it if she asks for. If she don't, I'm Cosby, then I'm back for. Yeah, you can do it. You can do it. Make a move. You can do it. Got a bad one who gon' lie. I just wanna hit it with the light. Yeah, baby, let me get you right.
It's our feast, gotta clap and scream. Tie me to her crib. I walk and she sleep. She say, but I live in the hills. Girl, that's just the way I sleep.
Money all around me. I look like I'm the man. But down like last week. Tell me, where have you been?
Radio.
Like I'm your man. I'm just a fan. You don't hold rain. No. Don't hold no.
Spinning ass nigga with a sick ass mouth and a slick ass flow.
Damn son, yeah. You just been cracked in the head with another DJ Young Kuda exclusive.
Ghost right there. Do it for my niggas and the ghost right now. Niggas got killed for the boy, living dreams in the hills, and they wasn't for the boy right now. Goddamn, what a yeah. We are what them young boys feel. I kill, never be killed. That's real, no lie. You can tell it from my peers right now. Don't you wanna fuck me now? Don't you wanna love me down? Girl, you can't tie me down like Ray J said, but no.
You're now in the mix with the young DJ Kuda.
Tonight we gon' be going in.
Let's
get it.
Player
Talk Radio.
Still getting rowdy in the function. Bitches on my dick like it's nothing. Everywhere I go now, always got shit bumping.
Hey, nice to meet. I'm young, hey, who you be? Peace, and Southeast. Gotta clap and creep. Tie me to her crib.
Damn, Kuda. Why you doing like that, baby?
That's just the way I sleep. Start that madness, I'm a savage. In traffic with Mac 11s. Bad bitch, and she's Spanish. I fired a cussle. Nasty, I'm her daddy. She know a nigga ain't average. Ain't nothing wrong, glasses. Bitch, turn around, let's make magic. I'm on it. Don't look at me like you want it. No. Tell them that we ain't starting. If wolf down, we ain't buying. Got this track Olympic.
Shout outs to my boy that after party.
One of
my favorite artists.
But I never ever call back. Maybe one time that's a real.
This some real shit right here. Listen to this shit.
In my fucking past. I don't know. Can I trust my heart? Can I trust my bro? I don't know. I don't know, yeah. But I know I got some heavy medical, yeah. And I know I got your bitch, she love to blow, yeah. And I know she love the way I
just get Molly some Molly, now I'm faded. Yeah, your girl gon' sell my deal like I'm famous. And I pulled up with them baddies that get wasted. Yeah, she calling me her daddy like I made her. I am not no Superman, I never save her. I don't save her, yeah, hey. When it starts coming for you, that's when I'll start running from you. I'll show you love that you want it.
Alright, y'all, let's get into the game.
And when it stops,
let's get into the game right quick.
I'll start running from you.
That was today's mix.
I'll hide the love that I give to you. And that I never knew you, oh yeah. Do a line with a Zen, miss a beam with a band, so she feel that. Bitch, get your ass on the pole. But in a split, she peeled it.
Right.
Hit it one time and I killed it. But I never ever call back. Maybe one time that's a relapse. Known to do that in my fucking past.
So listen, man, that was today's mix. All right, so let's get into the show, man. We got a lot of shit to talk about today, man. Let's get into the show, y'all. Let's get into the show, man.
Villains, and get into the mix. Where DJ Young Kuda drops some fly-ass game on you.
I'm about to. All right, so look. Turn the bass down for y'all, man. I don't know if y'all got a system that can handle all this madness that goes over here, that goes on over here at Player Talk Radio. Sign up. How y'all been, man? I'm feeling great, man. Listen, man. I told y'all to be safe, man. There's a lot of fuckery going on today, man. I'm looking at, on Facebook, man, I'm looking at, man, all kinds of shit going on today, man, and you don't hear shit. Remember I told you about these black feminists and all these old feminists and Shea Butter Twitter and all these, you know, these stupid broad groups that don't talk about no real shit? But they'll talk about me, man. If I get on their radar, oh man, they're gonna have a field day with my ass. So it's gonna be eventful. The day that happens, nigga, y'all start tagging me in that shit. We gonna have a blast, man. We gonna have a party, man. I'm gonna look out for y'all. If y'all look out for me, man. That's what I do with my fans, man. I give y'all some honesty. But look, man. There's another video out right now where this white dude, like, the police are searching for this white dude that punched the shit out of this security guard lady, and you know everybody in the, you know, was white, and she was the only black one, this, you know, the security guard lady that got punched, man. So it's like, damn, it's like all of this shit is happening and broads aren't saying shit. Like, there's no fucking committee of black women that's like, hey, hold on, man, this white man need to, you know what I'm saying? They don't come forward and they don't speak and they don't say nothing. Now, is that a coincidence? Fuck no. Like I told you, they're a part of white supremacy. They're a part of white supremacy. And not only does black people do not know how to stand up to white supremacy, our sisters definitely don't know how to stand up to no goddamn white supremacy. You see, I sit up here and I, like, you know, I read books and shit, you know, I read books, I look up shit, I study shit. It's sad, man. Our women aren't out here studying like that. Real shit. So ain't shit about to happen in that scenario. Another thing that happened. Oh boy. Now, there was a video that's going around of this black girl being hung and lynched and all that stuff. First of all, let me tell y'all, man, that video is fake. That's a piece of porn, but it's not really porn. It's called race play. So that video is fake. And, you know, there's a lot of talk about interracial relationships and stuff going on right now. You know, they got a term and a name for it. It's called swirling. Swirling. Oh, yeah, Cameron or whatever the fuck that bitch called herself. She's from the WWF. Yeah, she don't date black guys, you know. A lot of bad winching and shit going on, you know. BW is not going to stand for black women anymore, man. It's going to stand for bed witching. Also in news, fucking RG3, he proposes to his girlfriend like weeks after finalizing his divorce. And she's another white lady, man. So that's wild, you know. You know, black people are going to have to start calling out other black people for like treason and shit. You know, people that swirl and do all of this. Oh, fuck niggas, fuck all of this shit. And then you know, when some shit go down, they looking for us to protect them and shit. Or looking for the black community to back them. Or I don't know what the fuck they looking for, man. But we gotta have some type of treason laws amongst each other, man. Cause this shit getting wild. In other news, a married middle school teacher is caught in the car having sex with a 15-year-old student. Black lady. That's crazy. I already told you about them teachers, man. They freaks, man. Oh, and your girl, Miss Wright's Way. I think she was with my boy, brother. What is it? Brother Polite? Brother Polite out here doing his thing, too, man. I see Brother Polite out here doing his thing, man. Shout out to that boy, Brother Polite, man. He got an i8 BMW, man. Hey, man, that shit looks sweet. You know what I'm saying? I know he having a blast, man. So it's good to be conscious and also be paid. So, but at the same time, come on, Brother Polite, man. You got, well, I don't know if that's his baby. I don't think that's his baby. But Miss Wright's Way, she went out with my man, Brother Polite. I did a post last year about her where she was like swinging around this pole, cause she like pole, quote unquote, pole dances. She pole dances with her baby, and she has her baby, you know, with her, swinging around the pole and, you know, half naked and walking around and just swinging on this pole and shit. Hold on, man. I'm gonna have to cut the music for this one because y'all motherfuckers be tripping, man. Listen, man. Pole music. I said pole music. This is what she do to swindle half the people, man. There's no art in this shit. There's no glory in this shit. You know, she being slick. You a black lady bringing your daughter around fucking poles and shit. And you know what I'm saying? This is stupid. Like, and then people back it. They're like, oh, it's art. Oh my God, it's, you know, no. How she gets y'all is she puts like some art, magical music with it. You know what I'm saying? She puts like, I think on this video she has Kalani or some shit. And then she, you know, she be putting like some art music with it to make it seem like it's an art. But it's not. Because I swear to God, if she had put Tip Drill to that fucking video, the niggas would change their whole tune for that shit. So, you know, miss me with that bullshit that is art and shit, you know. I posed a couple of questions today. Thank you for the friends on my list that answered it. I said, you know, if Aaliyah was still around, would Beyonce had been as big? You know, I'm just recapping y'all what I was doing while I was on my little hiatus. And I said, you know, so, you know, if y'all want to answer that, you know, comment down below. I also said, if Tierra Marie didn't blow her Rockefeller deal, would she still have been as big? You know, would there still have been a Rihanna? That's what I meant. Not, would she still have been as big, but would there still be a Rihanna? Because, you know, if Tierra Marie didn't blow her little, you know, Rockefeller gig, you know, never know. Also on my little hiatus, I did a show with, you know, Digital Pit Boss, man. Shout outs to Digital Pit Boss and shout outs to my boy Black Ink. Black Ink did a crazy, brought to you in part by Digital Pit Boss. He did a crazy in-depth melanation sensation explanation. He went in, man, and you know, if anything you needed to know about Nature Boy and what's going on over there, you know, you gotta check that out on the Digital Pit Boss channel, you know, Digital Pit Boss radio show. So, on YouTube. And they actually did an interview with me, and I actually, you know, cleared up a lot of the things. So, man, that's a great interview, too. The streets fucks with it. The conscious community fucks with it. So, you know, I fucks with it. Just so much shit been going on. But, man, there's some topics I want to get into today. So, since we're talking about, you know, the swirling and, you know, the black girl and the white hole. You know, the white cuckolds. That they got, you know, because, you know, race play is something that's big out here, you know, especially in times right now, because, you know, white supremacy is imploding. And what's going on is that, you know, white supremacists, in a lot of ways, they're becoming more extreme and they're becoming more violent because, you know, they're on the decline. You know, they're the minority, you know, their numbers are like down like a motherfucker. But it's still a system that's in place. You see what I'm saying? This is good news and then it's bad news because, see, white supremacy is a system that it's a system that works really good and it's built on ignorance and it makes a lot of money. But the thing is that black people hasn't found a way to get rid of it. It's actually getting rid of itself by stupidity, imploding, social media, society, and other different things, you know. But what's bad is that, you know, if it wants to get revamped, it can get revamped. And black people will still wouldn't have a way to get rid of it. So that's the bad part. Another thing I want to talk about is, you know, treason in the black community, man. We need to have a code where, you know, when people just, you know, sell out black people like coons and shit and bed wenches and all these other people, they need to be held accountable, man. If you know them, like socially, they need to be held accountable. You can't say fuckers for this all this long time and then, you know, try to come back and shit. Fuck no. Oh boy. Another thing I wanted to talk about, man, is like, you know, hoes. Like, summertime's coming up. And let's just keep it real, man. Well, not even just summertime, just in general. There's, like, hoes out here, man. But I want to talk about hoes and their mood swings, man. And this is why... I know I'm segueing into a lot of shit. Hold on, let's take this whole shit down a taste real quick. Y'all give me 2 seconds, man. We're gonna get into today's game, man. I'm about to spit today's game. Give me 2 seconds right quick, all right? One moment. Let's talk about some hoes. Let's find some spitting music. Let's talk about some hoes, man. Let's get into the Santana bandana. All right, so I'm gonna talk about some hoes right quick, man. My favorite topic. It's hoes. It's not hoes. It is not hoes, y'all. Alright, so. Hold on. But who am I, though? Alright, man. So we're gonna talk about hoes and their mood swings, man. You know, it behooves a lot of people to realize, especially a lot of ladies, to realize that, like I said in the hump day game that I dropped last Wednesday. I didn't put it on my Facebook, but go check out my YouTube. Just YouTube DJ Kuda, man. You'll find all that shit. DJ Kuda. So hoes in their mood swings, man. Like I told y'all, man, ladies, y'all are receivers. Fellas, we are givers, you know. We give. We express. Your sexual organs. You have a penis. You have an external sexual organs, while women have an internal sexual organs. That's why they receive and you give. But I'm just saying. But what I want to say is that, you know, dudes be wondering, like, why these hoes got mood swings, or why these hoes act the way they do, and why why these hoes, you know, why they sleeping with all these people, why they doing all of this? Listen to me. Just like a woman that's not, but especially this woman, she is confused. A lot of them aren't confused. A lot of them know what the hell they doing. But a lot of hoes are confused, man, and their mood swings, man. You know, vagina holds DNA of sexual partners. Do you know that? The vagina holds your DNA. Your shape, your size, your strokes. The vagina holds all of that shit. Fuck what this bitch telling you. The vagina holds niggas' DNA. See what I'm saying? And the thing about it is, you gotta understand that, man, whether you wear a condom or not, the vagina's gonna hold your DNA, bro. Your energy, you know, you don't just, you know, other than the skin-to-skin contact, you know, when you're thrusting and you're pushing and shit, you know, you're pushing your energy in these bras, man. And ladies, you're receiving energy, man. Why you think sex feel good? What you think, just strokes alone and friction gonna feel good? No. There's some energy behind that, man. And your pussy holds the DNA, man. That's why they're so confused, because see, fellas, like I told you give a woman two seeds, which is your philosophy. It's your philosophy and it's your game. You know, I say your philosophy. Your game is your philosophy. It's your philosophy and it's your physical seed. You know, you give a woman a baby, you know? And you give her your game, though. Your game's supposed to back up, you know, your game is supposed to back up your philosophy with her, and that's all supposed to back up your seed. So you gotta understand that, you know, with your philosophy, it's gonna sustain your family, like your family structure. So even if y'all not having kids, you know, your sex game gotta be backed up by your philosophy. A lot of y'all niggas don't know that. Or maybe y'all don't care. So, you have to understand the game, man. This is what I'm trying to tell y'all guys, man. Y'all gotta understand the game, because, you know, your understanding of the game is gonna put you in a lot of positions, man. Good or bad. And so is your lack of understanding, man. When you lack understanding the game, man, it's gonna put you in a lot of fucked up positions. So you have to make sure you understand the game, because when you don't understand the game, it's going to get you fucked up. And when you do understand the game, you can see where you could have got fucked up and maneuver around all of that shit. And at the same time, you can control desired effects. You create situations, man. And when you create situations, you create the possibilities of things happening within those situations. Breaking down the game. So, you know, you gotta look at your views, man. You know, like, how do you view women? A lot of you niggas are stupid. Really. And you gotta live in the truth, man. You gotta understand the truth, man. A lot of you dudes fool yourself, man. That's why y'all gotta keep it real with yourself in your damn dating pool, man. Y'all don't know when truth hits you. Like, for example, a lot of you niggas think there's a such thing as a good girl and a bad girl. There's a good girl and a bad girl myth out here. That there's a good girl and there's a bad girl. Shout outs to my boy Mr. Locario, man. Dropped some great game. But the good girl and the bad girl is the same woman. Can y'all handle that truth? The good girl and the bad girl is the same woman. There is no good girl. There is no bad girl. These broads are both. Yes, she had a drink. Yes, she smoked. These broads are both. Come on, nigga. There is no such thing as a good girl and a bad girl. They're the same woman. They just present themselves differently for guys, you know, for different guys. They present themselves differently, man. They present themselves differently. This is why it's hard for you guys to accept the truth. This is why it's hard for you guys to be like, you know, this is why, I don't know what to say for y'all, man. or two, y'all, man. Y'all dudes are fooling yourselves, man. And it's sad, man. So, you know, you dudes just need to, you need to get up on some game, man. You need to learn about hoes, you know, you need to learn about, you know, you need to learn about a lot of shit, man. Hold on, let me get to some elegant shit. Let's talk about, let's talk more about some hoes, man. Alright. So when it comes to hoes, I'm just gonna talk a little bit about hoes. She can be the good girl and the bad girl, shit. I know some good hoes and I know some bad ones. This is just accepting the truth about shit, man. You need to get in tune with accepting the truth about shit, man. You never own the pussy, man. You're leasing it. That pussy ain't yours, it's hers. You never own the pussy, man. You're leasing it. You renting the pussy, man. That pussy, no matter how much time she says it's yours, it's not yours, man. I'm just saying. I'm just trying to give y'all a blueprint where your mindset has to be in the game. In and out of a relationship, where your mindset has to be, man. Listen, man, you fellas that's in the game that think you own the pussy, you have to be prepared, man. You have to be prepared as a man for a lot of different things that you don't understand, and that women don't understand, and that people don't understand, and that game that I'm bringing to your attention right now. Oh yeah, I'm bringing it to your attention. I talk to your mind. I get niggas' heads, man, with the shit that I say. If you can break down some game or understand some shit. So listen to what I'm about to say before I get up out the building. Because I got shit to do, man. Well, your mindset has to be in the game, in and out of a relationship. Listen, nigga, you can lose your bitch at any moment. You can lose your bitch at any moment. You need to prepare to lose your bitch at any moment. Don't think she gonna stay around. Don't think just because you're doing good or you're a good man. You have to be prepared to lose your bitch at any moment. This is shit that has to go through your head in a relationship, out of relationship, whatever you're doing. You have to be prepared to lose your bitch at any moment. And you have to be able to be attached to something while not being attached to something. This is a skill that you have to learn, man. You gotta be able to not be afraid to walk away. You need to learn this while you're dating. Not to be afraid to walk away from something, man. This is how you become a prisoner of some shit you shouldn't be becoming a prisoner for. Or about. You gotta be able to not have attachments to certain things. You gotta be able to tell you. Your woman has to know she can lose you at any minute. And at the same time, you need to know you can lose your woman at any minute. So you need to mentally plan what will happen if she goes away today. What will happen if some shit go down? What will happen? What are you going to do for yourself? How are you going to compose yourself? Same thing with you, ladies. Oh, this ain't just for niggas. You can lose your nigga anytime. This is just in a dating arena. This is the mindset that you need to have. You see, by all means, I'm a stern dude. I'm a real stern dude. Like, I know what I'm doing. I know what I'm doing. Just know that on both sides of the field, especially in the bedroom. I'm a beast. I'm a tiger. I'm a lion tiger. I'm a bear. I'm all that shit. This is the thing, man. And I don't mean to brag. This is not to brag. But this is, I want to get your I want to get you in a great mindset to what I'm about to say. You need to have enough confidence in yourself. And know when you're slacking too. You need to have enough confidence in yourself. Just like I do. And you have to understand that I know I can't keep a motherfucker faithful to me. Because, see, dudes get on this whole ego thing where, oh, man, I know if I beat that pussy up, I'm a keep somebody. Nah, that shit don't work, bro. And trust me, I've slanged, bro. I don't save them. I slave them. I did all of that shit. You have to understand. If she doesn't, if sex isn't like a big thing on her list, man, these bitches will do anything. You see what I'm saying? Or if you think you're doing something and you're really not, they prone to do anything. I am telling you, when you get into this game, you're going to see a whole bunch of wild shit. You think these bitches at home? No, the fuck they not. But what I wanted to say is that, you know, both of y'all got to be prepared to lose whoever you want. See, I know that I can't make a motherfucker faithful to me. I can't. That's their decision. But I damn sure know I can control them thinking twice about doing some shit. You see what I'm saying? See, this is where your confidence need to fall into a comfort zone. You can't make nobody be faithful to you. Shit, nobody can. But you can make that motherfucker think twice about being faithful to you, you know, fellas. You can be such a good man to your girl that if a nigga comes by with some offer, she know, like, listen, man, as much as I would like to take this nigga up on his offer, look, nobody ain't gonna give me what I got right now. Or he not gonna put up with my attitude or this, that, and the third. Or you can let her, you can make some shit go off in your women's head, man. And ladies, you can make some shit go off in your man's head. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of these bitches out here, for real, fellas, man, let's keep it a hun, done. They sport fucks. They sport fucks. It's a sport. You know what I'm saying? But look, man, that's enough on today's game, man. That's enough on today's game, man. If you got any questions, man, email me at playertalk8@gmail.com. That was today's show, man. It was pretty quick, man. We are back in the building, man. So listen, man, we're going to have some more guests on the show. There's a lot more surprises and things that's about to come. So listen, man, y'all fuck with me, man. It's the kid Young Kuda, man. Let's get into this motherfucking slowdown. You know, we got that Monday slowdown. You know I like my music slow, so let's get it. Let's go. Player Talk Radio. Oh yeah, man. And don't forget. Happy Mother's Day. I'm sorry. I'm late like shit. Happy Mother's Day to those mothers out here. And happy Baby Mama's Day to the single mothers out here. Let's get it.
What? They don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't. Same room, don't never say shit. Just keep it between me and you. And we cool, cause they don't know. I'm the one you be texting when you be up out. I'm the one that bought that Benz to see out the rock. I'm the reason you don't stress when shit gets hard. Anything you want is all yours.
They don't know.
On your birthday, I'm the one who saw your birthday suit. Got the Birkin bag, all that birthday coupe.
They don't know.
I keep it all real, I ain't gotta tell lies to you. You the only one who knows the truth.
They don't.
Never say shit. Just keep it between me and you. And we cool. Cause they don't know.
They don't, they don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't know.
They don't even know I know you. You don't be talking like a lame bitch. You follow all the rules. Be cool, be cool. We was at the same hotel, Super Bowl and All-Star Week. You be acting shy, but you really an All-Star freak. Bet you got my name tattooed on your body. They don't know you belong to me. Yeah. Code names and the secret trips. When I be up in that pussy,
I be calling you my bitch. They don't know you like me. They don't know you like me. They don't even know that I share you with my wifey. They don't know. They don't. They don't know. They don't. Say shit. Just keep it between me and you. And we stay on, cause they don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't know. They don't even know I know you. You don't be talking like a lame bitch. You follow all the rules. You keep it cool. You deserve, the rewards. G5 planes, you deserve the board. Tell them other lames they can swerve, of course. And I swear to God, I'ma curve them bros. Cause they don't know. Vacations, they don't go. You stay patient, and I respect that. Cause you know how to pay your post. Them other bitches get antsy. That's why a nigga never treat them fancy. You get yours off and bird off while they bargain shopping on Delancey. You ain't even tell your sister. Your mama thinking you don't even like niggas. Instagram, you don't even like pictures. That's why I'm fucking with you.
They don't know. They don't know. They don't know.
Turn the lights on.
They don't. They don't know. They don't know.
Yeah.
They don't. They don't know.
They don't know how
they don't. They don't know.
Yeah,
we be in the same room. We'll never say shit.
Never say shit.
Just keep it between me and you. And we cool, cause they don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't.
Strong piece of business.
They don't know. They don't, they don't know. They don't, they don't.
Wifey know about you though.
Talking like a lame bitch. You follow all the rules. You keep it cool.
Talk Radio.